Now, children, in this we have to study the replication of DNA, that how DNA replicate. We have studied the enzyme which is required for DNA replication. Now the process of replication. So the first process is activation of nucleotide. We all know that there are four type of nucleotide which is present, that is adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine. These are present in DNA, and in the nucleoplasm of eukaryote they are present in inactive form, whereas in the cytoplasm of prokaryote they are also present in inactive form. Now they have to be charged so that they become active and perform the process of DNA replication. Now what happened? They are present in inactive form. For example, adenosine is present in a form of AMP, means adenosine monophosphate. Then TMP, that is thymine, is present in a form of monophosphate. Then GMP, that is guanosine, is present in a form of monophosphate. And the other one is CMP, that is cytosine, is present in a form of monophosphate. Now what happened in all these? They have to be activated. And they are activated by enzyme called as phosphorylase. They are activated by an enzyme phosphorylase. I have told you earlier that for the function of phosphorylase. So this enzyme, what happened? The phosphorylase will add phosphorus to it. Now what happened? They will change from mono, they will change into tri, that is ATP, TTP, GTP and CTP. Now they are changing into this form and these are activated form. Okay, now it is changed. Now what happened? The nucleotide are activated. Now the second step that is going to be happen next. Listen student, I am telling you stepwise, but this was not happening stepwise inside the organism. These all process go simultaneously, whether it is in prokaryote or eukaryote. But for understanding, we are numbering it. That is first step, second step, third step. Ultimately, it was going on simultaneously in the body of the organism. Now, what the second step is the opening of helix. That is, the DNA is in a form of helical like this. It is in a helical form. Now it have to be opened. Now for the opening, there are something which is required. First is, for opening, first thing is required is ori. That is origin of replication. What is ori actually is? Ori is a short or a small sequences that are present, that is new special type of nucleotide sequences which are present, that was recognized by the enzyme, and from there the unwinding of DNA start. Now if we talk about the prokaryotic cell, there are only one ori will be present. But if we talk about the eukaryotes, then in one DNA there are more than one ori will be present. Okay. So more than one ori will be present, and to this ori the helicase enzyme is going to join the DNA. And what second step will take place here? That is binding of helicase to ori. Now binding of helicase take place to ori. Now here it will start unwinding. Now unwinding will start. Now how the unwinding will start, I'll show you in this diagram. You understand how DNA are coiled. Now what happened? From one end it start cutting. So suppose from here it is start cutting. Okay. So it become separated. I'm not making it coiled, but to understand so that you can understand, this is the coiled part. This will be the will be the 3 prime end and this will be the 5 prime end. This is the 5 prime end and this will be the 3 prime end. So the 2 strand of DNA get separated. From till here it is separated, but it is binded here. Actually the whole unwinding will not take place in one step. A small portion is unwinded, a new strand is formed, then the molecule will move further. Then other what happened? The DNA will open there. Then the formation will take place and then the previous one will coil with a new strand. So the whole DNA does not unwind in a single set, but it is unwinding take place in a small sets. So like this, the DNA get open out and this DNA, this is called replication fork. It is Y-shaped structure that is made and it is called replication fork. It is called a replication fork. Now what happened next? It is unwinded with the help of enzyme helicase. Now what happened? The topoisomerase. The topoisomerase will going to attach here because it is unwinded strand, so it is going to attach here so that it release the tension and the two strand remains separated. Because if it does not happen, then what happen when again the helicase will go further, then what happen? These two strands will again bind together by the hydrogen bond. So that should not happen. That is stopped by topoisomerase. And here also the enzyme single strand stabilizing enzyme is also going to attach so that the stability will remain maintained. So this also happen in this step. That is the opening of DNA. Now your DNA strand is open. Now the third step that will take place. That is formation of primase. And I have already told you that was done by RNA polymerase, which is DNA dependent RNA polymerase. It is said DNA dependent because it make the primer with the help of the DNA strand only. Because DNA strand is present with the help of this RNA primer is going, polymerase is going to make the small pieces of primer. So that's why it is called DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Okay, so the primer will start the formation of primer with the help of RNA polymerase. Now I have told you that the small segment of base pair that joined together, that is of about 7 to 8 base pair, that will be the RNA primer. And in RNA primer you will know that RNA thymine is replaced by the uracil. Now what happened, children? The process of attachment of primer will take place at 3 prime end only. Clear it is? The attachment of primer will occur at 3 prime only, end of 3 prime, because we know that if this is the strand, then one end is 5 prime and other end is 3 prime. You know that? Here the phosphorus is free and here the functional group OH is free. So where the next nucleotide is going to join? The next nucleotide is going to join at this functional group. That's why the addition of primer, of RNA primer, will always occur at 3 prime end, not at 5 prime end. And that's why, as the addition will take place in 3 prime end, that's why the process, the DNA formation, now the formation of DNA will always take place in a direction that is 5 prime to 3 prime end. Okay. RNA primer is going to join at 3 prime end always. Clear? Formation of DNA will occur in a direction that is 5 prime to 3 prime. Now, I'll tell you how. Children, suppose this is your opened part. Oh, sorry. This is our open part of DNA. Clear? This is our open part of DNA. Now, where there is, this is 3 prime. This is 5 prime. This is 5 prime. And this is 3 prime. Now, here the functional group is OH. Okay? Now the primer will start forming. The OH is present here, so here is P. The phosphodiester bond, here is P will be free. And here the OH. Okay. Now what happened to this OH? Next nucleotide will going to join to this next nucleotide. So here the OH at 3 prime end. So to the functional group, the next nucleotide is coming and joining together. So this will happen in this direction, that is in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. Now the other strand is from 5 prime to 3 prime direction. What happened here? Suppose I am bringing the RNA primer here. Okay. And I'm saying that it will join with, so here is P. Here is also P and the either here is OH. So with which OH? Here no OH is free. So with OH, this phosphorus is going to join. So it is unable to form the bond. So this will not happen. Suppose this portion is coiled. So it is 5 prime to now it has become 3 prime. It's 3 prime, but now I'm talking about this open point. Now what will happen? To here it will come, this is 3, either it will be 5 is going to join by the phosphoester bond and this OH become free, and now in this direction the formation of the joining of nucleotide will take place. So like this the formation of the addition of primer take place. So remember it, that addition of primer will always take place at 3 prime end, never at a 5 prime end, due to the OH group, that is the functional group, which is free at 3 prime end. At 5 prime there is a phosphorus group, not the OH group, and always the new nucleotide is going to join at 3 prime at the functional group first. So this will happen. Now one question more arises, why the first the RNA primer is added or why the direct DNA is not formed? So it is some technicality that DNA polymerase is unable to initiate the reaction. It need help of someone to start the reaction and then it will be held by the DNA polymerase. But so to start the DNA they required RNA polymerase, which make a small strand, and after that the new nucleotide of DNA strand is going to join. Now the third step is of, I have told you, that is formation of primer. Now the fourth step that occur is, that is now the DNA replication. Now the DNA replication occur. I am explaining you by the diagram. This is the DNA fragment which is open. This is 5 prime. Sorry, this is 3 prime. This is 5 prime. This is 5 prime and this is 3 prime. So here OH is free. Here phosphorus is free. Here phosphorus is free and here OH is free. Now what happened? A small segment of primer is going to join here. Here OH group is free. And what happened to this now? A new nucleotide is coming to it. Okay. The new nucleotide is coming to it. And the new nucleotide is going to join with this. One nucleotide that is on OH group. Then other nucleotide and then other nucleotide. Now what I have told you that in this also what happened, the primer were attached, but as this strand is open, so the primer is attached to this 3 prime end. And now the new nucleotide is going to attach in this direction. Okay, in this direction the formation of nucleotide take place. Now what happened? In next step, the DNA get unwinded more. Suppose now this much portion is unwinded and this much is left. Then in this, this is 3 prime, 5 prime, 5 prime, 3 prime. Here is the primer. And the nucleotide is going to join in this direction. As the OH group is free, so the nucleotide come in a continuous form and join here. Okay, from cytoplasm the nucleotide come and directly join the this chain. Now what happened to this side? As I have said, suppose till this diagram, till here it is open. So here the primer is present. And to this primer, what happened? The nucleotide is joined here. Now what happened? It ends. Because here the OH group is free and the here is the 5 prime, that is phosphorus group is free. Now what happened? The more DNA is uncoiled. So this is step. Now again this will become 5 prime and this will become 3 prime, this open strand. Now what happened at 3 prime end? Again one primer is going to join and to this primer again the nucleotide is going to join. So this will happen means in the direction, that is in our strand 3 prime to 5 prime which is going, in this strand the nucleotide is adding continuously. There is no another primer is added, only one primer is required to initiate the reaction and after that the nucleotide is continuously adding. So this strand is called as continuous strand. Now if we talk about the strand which is 5 prime to 3 prime, here what happened? First at 3 prime and 1 primer is added, then the formation of nucleotide will take place. Again there was primer is added and again this will happen. So this strand, the formation of nucleotide or joining of nucleotide is not continuous. So this strand is called as discontinuous strand. Okay. This step is called as discontinuous strand. Now what happened next? Like this, the process will go on till whole the DNA. Means at 3 prime to 5 prime, here is the 5 prime and here the next is 3 prime, here is the 3 prime and here is 5 prime. So the opposite strand is coming and joining together. Now the next step what happened is the removal of the primer. Removal of the primer will take replaced by DNA polymerase 1. The enzyme which is required, that is fifth step, is removal of primers, and this was done by DNA polymerase 1. Now what happened? The DNA polymerase will remove these primer and they add the subsequent nucleotide sequence here. They will remove the primer and they add the subsequent nucleotide sequence here. Now the next step that happened, these nucleotide sequence is added and the primer is removed. Now the joining of the nucleotide has to be take place. So that was the sixth step and that was done by ligase. Ligase are the enzymes which help in joining. So they will form a bond between them and they are going to join all the nucleotide sequence together. Now we'll see that this is the DNA strand in which only single primer is required, that is from 5 prime to 3 prime, which is going, new strand is going from 5 prime to 3 prime. So only single primer is required, so the nucleotide is going and joining together continuously. So this strand is formed faster than the other strand. So this strand is also known as leading strand. The strand is also called leading strand, and the other strand in which the other strand which is from 5 prime to 3 prime, in that we'll see the number of primer is attached to it and they have to be removed by the DNA polymerase 1. So it will be the process which be somehow later than that the previous strand. So this strand is called lagging strand, that is behind. A shorter behind with the that. This is called as lagging strand. And as a small pieces of a DNA is formed, means a primer, then a short DNA strand, then a primer, then a short nucleotide strand of DNA, then a primer, then a short nucleotide strand of a DNA. So these shorter strand of DNA are called as Okazaki fragments. These shorter strand are called as Okazaki fragment. So now these Okazaki fragment was joined with the help of ligase. As the primer is removed and they have to be joined together, so these are joined by ligase enzyme. Now the next step was proofreading. As maybe the DNA, the nucleotide which is coming from the cytoplasm or from the nucleoplasm, maybe some wrong nucleotide is come and join the sequence. So for that there should be a proofreading, so no unwanted nucleotide or no wrong nucleotide will come and join. And this proofreading was done by two enzyme, that is DNA polymerase 3 beta 2 unit will also do the proofreading, and nucleases, the enzyme nucleases will also do the proofreading. So these two enzymes, that is DNA polymerase 3 and DNA polymerase 3B specific unit, that is beta 2 unit, is going to do the proofreading, whereas the nucleases is also going to do the proofreading. So the proofreading was done by these two enzymes. And now what happened? These two strands are formed. Now one was the parent strand, this was the parent strand, this was the parent strand, that is from 3 prime to 5 prime and from 5 prime to 3 prime, this is open. Now the new strand which is formed, this is from 5 prime to 3 prime. And here also the new strand is formed, which is from 5 prime to 3 prime. Now these two, now from one single DNA of parents, two DNA are formed. That is this and they were going to join together, and now from this one DNA, two DNA are formed, and this is the process of DNA replication. And this process will occur in S phase of cell division. You have studied in class 11th what is cell division and what are the phases of cell division. So in the S phase, the process of DNA replication occur. Now one thing more, that due as the DNA is replicated and somehow the cell does not divide, then what happened? Then the condition of polyploidy will occur. The cell has, the DNA is duplicated, that it is from one it is formed two DNA, and the cell division does not able to occur. Then in one cell there are two DNA strand, and these will go and suppose there is a gametic cell and the separation does not able to occur, then they will result in a formation of polyploidy, that is more than one segment of DNA is present in them, that is more than one chromosome will be present in them. So that is the condition how the polyploidy occur during the failure of cell division. That is the replication will occur in S phase, and if further step does not occur in cell, then they will result in polyploidy. Now children, this is the DNA replication, and next we'll go through the transcription of DNA, that is formation of mRNA from